Hallo und willkommen zurück zu Underrail. Und bevor ich jetzt hier irgendwo was weitermache, werde ich erst nochmal gucken, wo ich diese Kultisten finde und ob ich mit denen sprechen kann. Und ob ich denen hätte beitreten können, denn wie wir gesehen haben, kann man nur einer Fraktion beitreten und ich weiß jetzt nicht, ob diese Kultisten eine Fraktion sind oder nur so ein. Ja, so ein kleiner Hideout. Chart is Evolution! Minister Percival. You find yourself in front of a man wearing beautifully ornamented robes. He stands tall and confident, with a chiseled face and radiant green eyes most would kill for. What is most striking about him is his unusual stare. It appears to be constant, never changing, neutral, but every time you see it, you perceive it in a different manner. One moment it strikes you as benevolent, wise, even paternal, the other it makes you feel exposed and apprehensive. He projects his voice without effort and speaks in calm, non-rushed manner with a slight drag at the end of each sentence. Show this evolution, brother! I am Minister Percival and I am a member of Institute of Charts. Fear us not, for we mean no harm, even though our appearance might suggest otherwise. The ropes look pretty neat, don't worry about it. I try not to have any prejudice based on appearance. Why don't you people wear something a bit less freaky? Well, the dark and scary robes definitely don't help the image. Indeed, we are aware of our clothing and its ability to deter certain kinds of people. Our uniforms are usually described as disgusting or creepy. He smiles lightly. On the other hand, we have an unmistakable and distinct appearance, something we embrace to symbolize the regenerative cycle of Chort itself. Now it lies in deep caverns, formless, rebuilding itself. Once ready, it will manifest into a new, improved being adapted to this world. Our robes honor this alteration, for we too are undergoing change, and once the robes are removed, we will reveal our new, improved form. Vielleicht will ich denen doch nicht beitreten, sind doch Freaks. Sounds interesting. What can you tell me about this Institute of Chort you belong to? Institute of Chort is an institution devoted to Chortism and was founded by Edin, who first discovered Chort nearly a century ago. Chortism is an ideology centered around Chort, a being that possesses and brings us immense knowledge and is the key to advancing, evolving the human race to new heights, literally, he smiles. Scientific investigation lies behind everything we do. We study the creature and its complete genetic makeup and learn from it. Then we apply the knowledge in practice. Tell me more. Tickled your imagination? Good. Chort exists as a physical being, observable, tangible, yet not able to fully communicate with us in its current state. But it gifted us with its flesh and through scientific investigation, as if I've already mentioned, we discovered that what was previously thought to be junk, DNA actually contained a genetic code that serves a sort of backup for the creature. The explanation is lengthy and requires a bit of time and will. That's fascinating. Glad you're finding it interesting. He makes a brief pause, then continues. You know what? We hold lectures about Chortism here in Core City. If you want to learn more, come and attend one of these lectures. I think that's a more effective way to comprehend the subject. Proven, he smiles. I'd like to attend the lecture you were talking about. Very well, or as some of us Chortists would say, Apex. We'll be holding a lecture quite soon. In fact, if you wait just a bit more, just a bit for others to arrive, we will be able to begin. Begin lecture. Ich schreibe mal gerade was auf. Thank you all for taking the time to be here today and for putting your trust in us in the midst of all that has been happening lately in Core City. The corrupted Faceless are known for ravaging everything they lay their dystrophic eyes on, and the us Chartists know that very well. We have a long history in dealing with those monsters and have always opposed their foul ways. We understand that during hard times it can be very difficult to put trust in something you're not familiar with. Yet amazingly, more often than not, dire situations are the cause for people to explore alternative options. Believe my words, during this lecture you will receive nothing but absolute undiluted truth regarding Institute of Chart, Chartism and what it can offer to you. Let us begin. First of all, I feel it is important for me to say that we are not a religious cult, as we are commonly accused of being. We don't worship imaginary beings, gods, devils or the like. Our robes do not exist so that we may intimidate. We have a symbolic value. They have a symbolic value, which will be explained later. Everything I tell you during this lecture is based on hard evidence, on research, on scientific investigation. Every claim here is backed up by careful and extensive research performed within Institute of Chart, under the watchful eye of Adin, its founder. But what is Chart exactly? Chart is a single multicellular organism discovered by Adin almost a century ago in deep caverns, and is suspected to be one of the oldest living organisms in existence. A primordial being. It is completely formless. It exists in a state of regeneration, which it undergoes whenever the environment it lives in greatly changes, requiring a different form to survive. Adin discovered it during its current regeneration cycle, and the creature allowed him to study it. What he learned during these studies was truly magnificent. First, I need to discuss the term non-coding DNA, sometimes referred to as junk DNA. Non-coding DNA, in simple terms, are DNA sequences of an organism which do not encode protein sequences, and therefore have no direct biological functions. For example, almost 98% of human DNA is non-coding, with only around 2% of the total genome being responsible for what you are, how you look, how you behave. Chart, only 0.5% coding, but there is a neat little secret. Its non-coding sequences serve as a sort of biological backup for the creature to rebuild its coding DNA. If damaged by radiation, mutations, or simply by a large number of replications, it modifies and also adapts for specific needs. In short, it can undergo a process of regeneration and adaption until it builds itself anew and perfects itself for the world it lives in. Adin found this remarkable, but what is even more is the fact this knowledge allows us to do the same thing with humans as well. Institute of Chart was soon born with the single unified idea to direct the evolution of the human race. Chartist's ideology reflects just that. We will preserve Chart and valuable knowledge it bestowed on us so that we can bring ourselves to new heights. We live in a desolate world, and the environment is not our only enemy. Just look at the recent events, and you will understand my point perfectly. Institute of Chart gravitates toward adapting the human race to move beyond these dark caves and reach the surface. Again, Everything I just told you can be backed up with solid proven facts. Chort is evolution, and evolution is Chort. One cannot go without the other if we are to stop ourselves from ultimate demise. And with that, I will end this short lecture. I know you have many questions, brothers and sisters, and know that these questions can and will be answered. To get to these answers, one would need to travel to Institute of Chort in Upper Underrail and become a Chortist. Only then can you have the access to all knowledge we possess and help us further understand Chort to help not just us Chortists, but our whole race. Please understand that Chort is important to us, and so it is to you. And we must propagate this knowledge to all who are willing to listen. As Aedin once stated, we can and we must. I hope you've learned some valuable information during this lecture. That is all for now. Thank you. Chort guide you. Institute of Chort in Upper Underrail. Okay. Chort is evolution. How may I help you? I wanted to talk to you about that lecture. I see, brother. Tell me, did you enjoy it? It was rather interesting and really got me thinking. I am very pleased to hear that. As I have already mentioned during the lecture, if you want to have unlimited access to our knowledge, you could visit us in Upper Underrail. Lines and lines of people stand in the Institute's courtyard, waiting to be accepted as members of our institution. While the competition is strong, those who possess certain traits will always have an advantage. Please consider it, brother. What can you tell me about the oligarchy? The oligarchs allowed us to be here under the protection. And under their protection, we are allowed to propagate knowledge uninterrupted. While there are certain matters regarding them which can be commented on, I'd rather avoid doing so. It would be rude to our hosts, in my opinion. Have you perhaps been to a Hardcore City Bar? I haven't personally been to this place, but some of my brothers and sisters have. It seems very devolved. They do it mostly to discuss Chortism with as many people as possible, which is understandable due to the popularity of it. What I found peculiar, though, is that the missionaries absorbed several local terms there. For example, I've heard phrases like, "That's freaking hardcore," or "zoon out," being uttered by them on a worrying number of occasions. If this trend continues, a certain form of intervention might be necessary. You understand, Core City slang sounds very unfitting for Chortists. I met one of you guys in Foundry, but he seemed pretty derailed. If he seemed derailed, then he probably is. I hope you realize that some madman's behavior shouldn't reflect on the doctrine of the group he claims to be part of. If you want to learn the true magnificence of Chortism, talk to me or any other proper Chortist missionary. I'll get going. Chort guide you on your travels. Okay, also der scheint hier nur ein Außenposten zu sein, aber nicht ganz die Fraktion zu repräsentieren. Ich hoffe es zumindest. Wird uns aber zumindest auch sagen können. Wo wir das andere finden können. Da steht nur Upper Underrail. Das hilft uns natürlich jetzt nicht so wahnsinnig weiter. Na gut. Ich meine, schlussendlich sollten es ja hier auch nur drei Fraktionen sein. Die von den Oligarchen. Also dieses Protectorate. Dann diese einen Typen, diese Technik-Hoshis und JKK, die mit diesem Blut und Dings da, denen die Arena gehört. Car City Dominative, sagt Eric. Norman, you come up to an average height blonde man holding a real book in his hand, reading it quietly. He is dressed in a stylish high-cost suit while wearing equally fashionable shoes, all free or even or a speck of dust. Meanwhile, his physique is as unimpressive as his gelled hair. Seeing that an average South underrailer can break him in two without breaking a sweat, he closes the book, takes a brief look at you, and begins the conversation with an entirely unique greeting. Ken Ho, approacher! Ken Ho! A joyful smile materializes on his face. Ah, finally someone who is not an uncultured swine. You speak at Ventong, yes? You speakish at Ventong, yay? No, I just repeated what you said. Sehr gut. Yay! Okay, final a person that speakish at Ventong in Core City. All body here is using common tongue, so yay. Atom Beverly mind clonking toller. Tallest tenant dem speaking primitive. I lost you. I don't have a clue what you're talking about. Yay? Gertrudis, Trutis, realization, what a new title given. Yay? A dull expression overcomes his so far joyful face, and you manage to spot a barely noticeable twitch on the side of his lips. You have no idea what I'm talking about, right? Yay? I understand some of it, but not everything. I don't think you understand me at all. And for an instant I thought I found someone who comprehends me. No matter, since you're already here, I might as well educate you, if only a bit. Here now. The language you witnessed me using is called Adventang, and it is contemporary, modernized and improved version of the language most of us use, Common Tongue, as I will refer to it from now. For you see, I was feeling indisposed and exhausted for all the inconsistencies, and how do I express myself? Unnaturalness of a common tongue. Thus, I, Professor Norman Heck of the University of Dis, one day made a conscious decision to liberate some of my time, sit down and do my best to ameliorate this stale mess into some endearing, beautiful language. Much pretty tongue. It resembles the common tongue, true, but only to a menacing degree. For instance, common tongue was a language dominated by exceptions to rules, relying on memorizing phonic patterns in order to maintain proper pronunciation and strict sentence structure. I could go on and on. All this has been evicted in Advantang, for the whole language has been standardized and tuned toward absolute consistency in every aspect imaginable, creating a clearer, more natural lingual expression, free of ambiguity, much pretty. There's so much more to speak of it, but first I'd like you to tell me why you're here and what do you want from me. I noticed the guy outside also speaks Advatang. Ah, yay, Rick Gentleman. He's my student and bright young man, I must say. I started teaching him shortly after I had arrived in Core City. I rented this, how to refer to it without making it seem better than it actually is, space here, and I put up an Advatang course ad. Rick Gentleman was the first one to respond to the ad, and he was the only one to respond to the ad. He clearly realized the importance of a Tvatang, unlike other denizens of the linguistic cesspit. I mean, even despite my disapproval for common tongue, the things I've heard here made my ears bleed and my mind wail in agony. being hammered in the head with hardcore and dominating every 2 seconds is only the beginning of the story. Pipe worker, atrocity. Etwatang as an official language of, well, even a station, let alone a region, will have to wait. However, I hope that goal will be achieved one day. If that means teaching one student at a time, then I better preserve. Persevere? Keine Ahnung. Can you teach me some Etwatang phrases? You wish to learn a few phrases? Wonderful! It is my aim to profilerate the number of Etwatang speakers, as you may have already deduced. What phrases are you interested in? Hello. That is an easy one. It's Ken Ho. You already heard me say that one when we met. Be careful. A in Ken is pronounced like A in cargo. Aho! Hello! Okay. Goodbye. Gah, it's a very simple word. Gone ho! It's quite simple, similar to kan ho. Naturally, you could also use a more complicated phrase like observant u sokos, soklos, which is more similar to see you around, or you could even say gargan, which is unique to Etwatang. It's a word that expresses a happy goodbye. You look very nice today. Oh yay, that one is you apa much pretty ao. It is a beautiful language, isn't it? Curtsy, or mean good, is the foundation of Etwatang. Should you decide to learn more of the language, you will see that it contains countless words which do exist in common tongue. Words which convey gently and refinement in such way that once you look back at the language you used before, it seems like you were cursing with every word you uttered. It makes you feel like a peasant. You ugly bastard! Nay, nay, nay! Why use such a harsh language? Etwatang is meant to be beautiful and amiable. He sighs. Well, technically you can say, you unattractive schlomor, but please do avoid unpleasantries. You should die in a fire. Watan! Of all the innumerable phrases you I could teach you in Etwatang, you chose this? He sighs. It's u-hot-hot-srnk. Good job. You mean with Etwatang? Oh, thank you, it's true. I rarely get the recognition. Truth is. Oh, you mean you want me to? Nah, sorry. Good job is good wakan. Redhound. Skvik samush. Disgusting animals. Unattractive. Yay. I'm going to pulverize your bones and smash your skull to tiny bits. Please don't, why such hateful language? I don't think I even have a word for pulverize, but I'll give it my best to appease your hunger for violent language. I is will much broke, your white dick and boom ur mint canta to so hard recept totos. So violent, Jesus. I've had enough of this, let's talk about something else. Yay? What can you tell me about Core City? It's just like most of South Underrail stations, linguistically perverted to the point of creating an impression that commoners who live here are struggling with their very own language. And I thought Common Tongue, in its untainted form, was abhorrent enough. I just dread that one day the way commoners converse here won't slither into my own speaking in some perfidious way. Ich muss ja gerade noch mal was notieren. Wie ist seine Sprache? Etwatang? Indeed, coming here was a much mind-clonking experience. If it wasn't for my student, I would have gone insane listening to those JKK workers discussing their trims and other menial things. What can you tell me about Arena? Gar that buffoonery? Buffoonosart, please, I don't wish to speak about it. Arena is the sort of thing that appeals to only the most primitive southerners, which is the majority. What can you tell me about JKK? JKK, as soon as I open my doors, I am greeted by the sight of their headquarters. They broadcast that dreadful arena, feeding it into the unwashed masses. On top of it, they organize betting to further relieve the poor creatures' already barren pockets. Their heads are already desolate, so why not their pockets too? I'd rather not have anything to do with JKK, do not do. And I have no better opinion of Cortec and Praetorian security for that matter. Primitive lot. What can you tell me about the oligarchy? I haven't personally met the Feuzatanrul. The oligarchs, that is. My information on them is limited, I'm afraid, but my personal experience, mostly from observation, but also other unfortunate incidents, dictates that I can only draw a single conclusion, which is that they are managing this city in selfish, incompetent, and rather oppressive manner. Yeah, at least no one disturbs me anymore, if we ignore the environment itself, that is. See you around, Norman. In Atvatang it is Observant Usoslos, Norman gentleman. Remember that, please. Okay. Norman gentleman in Steach me Atvatang, and now Rick gentleman. Just accept Albert, the uneducated mind. Oh god. Okay. Ich nehme an, dass hier nicht viel sein wird. Die werden uns wahrscheinlich auch nicht reinlassen. Wird nur sagen, ja, hallo, wir sind die und die und tschüss. Desk. Ja, danke. The man stops typing and looks at you. Welcome to JKK headquarters, Mr. Cordanor. Mr. Cordanor, nice to meet you. My name is Van. How can I help you? I'm looking for some work. Very good. And what kind of work are you looking for? Something fun that pays good. He laughs. Aren't we all? Well, if you excuse me for a brief moment, I'll see if we happen to have anything available. Van presses a button on his headset and starts speaking to someone. You pretend not to listen, but you can hear your name being mentioned a couple of times. The man remains almost expressionless, yet you somehow catch that there's something wrong. After several minutes, the conversation ends. Mr. Cordano, I'm very sorry, but we can't offer you a working position here at JKK at the moment. The reason for this is, if I've been told correctly, that you are already working for a different organization. I apologize again and wish you a dominating day. Thank you for your time. Goodbye. Good day, Mr. Colonel. How can I help you? What can you tell me about JKK? JKK is the major broadcasting organization in Core City. We make sure every arena match brought to everyone in both South and North Underrail. Even the poorest Zunas get the chance to experience the brutality of the arena. Moreover, for those interested in betting on arena matches, JKK is the organization responsible for it and much more. Without JKK, Core City would not be what it is today. So long. Ja, da war nicht viel. Dann können wir hier auch schon wieder gehen. The knowledge we have acquired from Chort will change the world. Praetorian security might have the numbers, but we have the tech. Da kann man auch wieder reingrapschen. Welcome back, sir. How may I help you? What can you tell me about Cortec? Cortec is the primary technology, research, manufacturing and application company in Core City. Being a successor to the Great Biocorp, Cortec employs some of the brightest minds in solving difficult problems of today. Cortec's desire to make a better future for everyone through technological advancement remains unmatched. Are we going now? Na gut. Dann haben wir hier das soweit durch. Da gibt es soweit nichts mehr. Also von einem von den dreien muss man sich entscheiden. Wir haben halt jetzt die Praetorians, was okay ist. Und dann gehen wir jetzt noch nach Upper Metro Station. Aha. Travel by Metro, wo kommen wir denn da hin? Praetorian Bomber. Beryl. Sammy und Zilla. Beryl. Oh ja, coole Musik. The young woman greets you with a broad smile, revealing an incisor gap as well as the fact that most of her lower jaw teeth are notably crooked, as if someone took a handful of differently colored teeth and then just pressed them into her gums until they stuck. Still, there is no doubt that this imperfect smile has a charming and unique quality. A greeting soon follows. Ah, good day to you, mister. My name is Zilla, and you must be hungry, she laughs. What can you tell me about the arena? It's this reason people come to Core City, to witness the most beautiful carnage available under rail, she laughs. Some say it's cruel and evil and all that nonsense, but all contestants are there voluntarily. Voluntarily! They fight cause they want the fame and the coin. So if you got the time off to see some hardcore domination, check it out, you won't regret it. You also won't regret tasting some of the food I've got to offer. How do you feel about the Faceless Invasion? Well, it's a weird situation. When I first heard that the Faceless were cutting us off from the north, I panicked. I'm not gonna lie, it's hardcore stuff, you know what I mean, with the tunnelers and all that nonsense. The Praetorians managed to hold their advance for now, but I still got a bad feeling about it all. I heard the Faceless steal people and turn them into cyborgs, into more Faceless. That is true. Then they aren't going to stop until we've all been converted. Well, they aren't gonna catch me. No, I'm gonna drop off a ledge if they ever get into the city. This is all nonsense. Hardcore nonsense. Do you know Mo, by any chance? He has a stall on the lower level. The instant you mention his name, her so far pleasant and amiable face gets shattered by an erupting volcano of emotions, and its hot fragments fly toward your face, scorching it. Yet she keeps silent, waiting for the inner boiling to die down, and soon enough it does, allowing her fissured, charred to face to revoke back to the same one as before. Almost the same. She speaks with a more reserved voice. We will not talk about him. Is that understood? Let's pretend you never mentioned him. And all will be well. And hardcore. What's wrong? What did Mo ever do to you to deserve that much hate? Do not let me repeat myself. We are not discussing him. Whatever, woman. It's no big deal anyway. Let me ask something else. Her glare flies up a bit, but gets quickly extinguished. She doesn't respond, however. I feel hungry, let's see what you have. Müll. Foodstuffs. Yeah, das habe ich da in den Dings gefunden. Ach, die kauft nur zwei Foodstuffs. Na ja, dann. Dann gib mir da. Danke. Just one step, Sammy, just one more step will end your problems. Ja. Foundry Guard is nothing compared to our enforcers. Will ich nicht hin. Okay, da geht's runter. Gehen wir erstmal. Oder ich guck mal, wohin dieser Zug denn überhaupt fährt. Polemos Station, Fort Apogee, Epion Lab, aus 25 Charons University, Nowhere. Habe ich schon erwähnt, dass das Spiel riesig ist? Guck mal, wo geht's denn dahin? Bandit, Bandit. Okay. Das war das Gleiche, oder? Ja. Wo kommen wir denn hin? Oder gehen wir erstmal hier noch entlang? Aber schon sehr leer aus. Motioner, ein einzelner. Bringen wir den gerade um die Ecke. Ich glaube, der greift mich an, sobald ich reinkomme, oder? Nö. Silence, he whispers. The big eye is watching you, watching us. Okay. Wo kommen wir hin, wenn wir da runterlatschen? Oder da runterlatschen? Oder da runterlatschen? Aha. Big pile of junk. This pile of junk offers nothing other than awful reek. The flies, on the other hand, must think otherwise. Na gut, bevor ich da jetzt zu den nächsten Dingen laufe oder hinfahre, werde ich erst nochmal ganz unten fahren, mit dem Typen reden, worüber wir jetzt mit ihr geredet hatten. Und City Gate Metro. Mit Mo. Only Zonas eat disgusting barrel soup. Real men and women eat at Mo's. What can you tell me about Zilla? Oh, Zilla. There's not much to say about that dirt woman. She used to have a store just across from mine. I don't even know why did she choose that location, since I already had mine set up here. She had nothing special to offer, and yet she wanted to compete. I had more customers, naturally, because my food doesn't taste like it was soaked in siphoner fat, but that crooked teeth nightmare started acting all derailed. She yelled at me for somehow stealing her customers. I mean, what? She didn't pass the opportunity to kick my stall a couple of times. The Praetorian security enforcers got her out of here soon after that, all hardcore, so she had to move to the upper underrail station, from what I have heard. Meh, I don't care anyway. Good riddance. You mentioned barrel soup. What is that? He laughs. Barrel soup is a type of soup that originated from Dropzun and has been around for a long time. The recipe is simple. Take whatever is edible and put it into a barrel full of water. Heat it up and eat it when it's ready. That's all there is to it. A full barrel can last a long time and feed a lot of Zunas. But why barrels? Beats me. Maybe they didn't have anything else to use, but apparently, from what I've heard, each barrel adds a different and unique taste to the soup. Yes, you heard me right. I often hear Zunas talking about the best barrels to use. Some of them even refuse to eat from a different barrel. They just add water and ingredients to the single one they think is the most hardcore and eat from it. No, no, why would you even think? No, I value my life, and if you value yours, don't ever try barrel soup, not even a sip. Nothing from me now, goodbye. Dann gehen wir nochmal nach oben. Nö. Na gut, dann nochmal zum Shop. Beziehungsweise da zu dem zu The Beautiful. Eventuell kann der mir sagen, wo ich den einen Typen finde, den ich für die Praetorians kaputt machen soll. Eventuell haben die auch hier wieder schon ein Reset bekommen. Electronic Device, Electronic Parts, Energy Weapon. Jo. Frame. Kann ich sogar noch ein bisschen mehr verkaufen, glaube ich. So viele Energy Weapons hatte ich ja gar nicht. Also eigentlich gar keine mehr. Hätte ich die unten reingelegt? Nee. Nochmal. So, Blueprint Leather Armor will er haben. Pistol Frame kann er auch haben. Component Quality 72. Das hier ist eh besser. High Frequency Shield Modulator. Sonic Mentor Thermodynamic Destabilization. Können wir eh nicht brauchen. Shield Modulator. Behalte ich mal. Field Stabilizer. 206. Plasma Core. Aha. So, was will der haben? Firearm Parts. Firearms, 2, 3 Melee Weapons, 1 Metal Armor, 3, also alles Mögliche. Auf jeden Fall mehr, als wir dem anbieten können. Das Ding ist ja schon 7000 wert. Nehmen wir noch ein paar Billigsachen rein. Ja, damit hat er schon fast alles weg. Coin 5. Ist noch 150. So können wir eine Kugel draufpacken. Blast Cloth. There's a bolt of Blast Cloth which can be used to enhance protection from impacts of explosions. Bolzen verkauft er wieder keine. Was ist das hier? Lifting Belt. Nee. Trade. Haben wir den auch wieder um sein Geld gebracht. Der hat ein paar Bolzen. Was will der? Nur Food und Bullets. Super. Na gut. Legen wir das hier wieder weg. Das heißt, ich einen Kram müsste man unten reinlegen. Na gut, das hier geht noch da rein. Das ist so Medizin. Da haben wir noch ein Etikett-Card aus dem Manor. Die muss unten in die Kiste. Ach so, und hier war ja auch noch, da waren noch so Banditengruppen, die ich auch noch abmurksen wollte. I need specific information. And that's what I'm saying. Prepare some food and let's get started. I'm looking for Joe DiPacino. That's easy, but it'll cost you one eel sandwich. My tummy yearns for it. I don't have that at the moment. I'll be back when I do. See you around. Okay, können wir gerade kaufen. Have you heard of Joe DiPacino? I don't think I have. I know a lot of people in Core City, but DiPacino? Sorry, but no. Can't remember anyone that goes by that name. Yes, you do, and you're going to tell me where to find him. No, I don't. I already told you. Please stop asking me about him. Now, what can I bring you, mate? Müsste man einen höheren Wert haben. Den kann man nur einmal fragen. Hm, 30 reicht nicht. Okay, aber ist egal. Dann mach mal. Fragen mich nicht danach. Kaufen ein Eel Sandwich. Da. Also auf jeden Fall noch ein bisschen Platz. Come here, baby. No, not you. I was talking to the sandwich. Sometimes the digestion is better if you talk to your food. Anyway, about Joe, just head north of here and you should see a guard to the right on the platform. There's like this small metal shack there. The guard is one of DiPacino's men. You figure out the rest, pal. He laughs. Nasty buggers. Also, I heard they do business with Cortec. Dirty business. There's some free info. He bites into the sandwich, and soon after, an expression of bliss appears in his face. Oh, this one's good. I talked to Sneaky about your relationship. So she told you everything, huh, Paul? Good, that is nice, good. I didn't mean to offend you or anything like that. No, I'm not offended. I mean, you asked Sneaky about our relationship and she told you she left me, right? It's okay, pal, it's okay. Nothing to worry about, nothing at all. Are you sure you're okay? I'm feeling great. Listen, pal, it's cool. We're cool. I mean, you just unstitched a wound in my heart and by mentioning her, but that's okay. Please, if you want to hurt me some more, here, put a knife right through here. He points to his heart. That's where my broken heart is. Sigh. That's what I'm talking about. You understand me? We're cool, pal. We're cool. My heart won't heal, but we're cool. See you around. Okay, dann werden wir diesen Pacino-Dings da mal umnatzen. Allerdings dann beim nächsten Mal. Denn das wird alles in allem wohl ein wenig länger dauern. Also, bis denn!